Hello people, so we are back with our new tutorial number 5. In this tutorial we are going to discuss, let me first explain that what things we are going to discuss in this tutorial. This tutorial is going to discuss the most important feature of AngularJS, that is two-way binding. In this tutorial we are going to capture what is two-way binding, what is the use of two-way binding and why we need two-way binding. So before explaining how we use two-way binding or what is two-way binding, let me show you one example. So for that I'm inserting two blocks. Suppose this block represents our controller and this block shows our UI. In this controller, suppose we have defined one variable, $scope dot first name. I'm taking example of suppose there is some page, some particular page in your complete application that is known as a student page that you have defined. Now student page will have one own controller. Suppose it is a student controller. You can modify the name here and UI will be common for anything. Suppose this page is for a student HTML UI. So we have one field, first name, and now in future we are giving a student that privilege, that authority to modify his first name or any other field. Suppose there are some more fields like scope dot last name, $scope dot age of that student, $scope dot address. So these are the four fields that are defining the student's properties, okay? And he comes to his profile and now he wants to modify that. To modify that, in HTML page we use form. See, actually I hope that you must be knowing about the HTML. I'm not going to explain any HTML tags in this tutorial because HTML is the basic thing that you must be knowing, like HTML forms, HTML tags, HTML input box, HTML text area, because before learning AngularJS these things should be clear to you, okay? So let's go back. So these are the four fields that is currently lying in a student's controller and showing it on UI, okay? Now a student comes to his profile and he wants to modify his first name, his last name and age and address, okay? So AngularJS provides us two-way binding, like defining the first name in controller and showing it on UI. On UI, how we show the variables is something like this, as we have discussed in the previous tutorial, that double opening curly braces, double closing curly braces and the name of the variable, whatever we have defined in controller. Now he wants to modify this. So one way by binding is defining some variable in controller and showing it on UI. Two-way binding means we can now modify this variable, this will be first name, we can modify this variable and automatically by changing this variable should also be changed, okay? Just understand that we are, one way you are already understanding that we are defining some variable and we are showing it on UI. The second way is, if we modify this variable or any other variable, you can take, like we are taking second name also here, for showing on UI, the age also we are taking and showing it on UI, and the last is address. Now that student comes, okay, into his profile, he logs in and he comes into his profile and he want to modify his all detail, first name, last name, age, address, all thing. So now AngularJS what does, it has given the best feature that if you modify this first name, the $scope that first name will also get modified automatically. This is called two-way binding in AngularJS. If you modify last name, that variable containing $scope dot last name will also get modified, and this is two-way binding. It means one-way binding, showing data on controller, defining data on controller, showing it on UI, and second binding is modifying data on UI and automatically these variables will be changed according to whatever variable you are changing on UI. So I hope you have understood what two-way binding is. Now let us take an example and explain what two-way binding is. This was technical term, so just understand this, and now I will implement it and show you. So let me close this. Let us go back to our main page. So before starting any AngularJS application, the first thing that we will have to do is we will have to connect our HTML page to Google API, and that will contain all the scripts written in angular.main.js. Now let us define our parent directive that is written with ng app equals to my app. Let us define, in this tutorial we are going to take only one controller. We are not going to take multiple controllers because you already have learned in the previous lecture that how multiple controllers are written. Since our main motive in this tutorial is to show you what is dynamic binding or two-way binding. Now we give some name controller one to this controller, and let's write the script. For that you will have to create one script opening and closing script tag where app equals to angular dot module. So this is my app. This is the way of defining any reference, creating any reference variable for the parent directive. Now this reference variable is ready and it can access any controller. So let's pass the name of our controller, that is my controller CTRL1. Sorry, I have defined some other name. Let's keep it same on both the places. Okay, and now create one function and $scope. Okay, $scope variables we are going to take. So let's define only three variables I'm taking, but always remember the concept will be same for other variable also. So my name is AngularJS. Okay, $scope dot last name equals to, I'm just picking random variables, so don't worry for that. I am first version of AngularJS. And one more thing, let's take that address. My origin is, sorry, spelling is not correct, so let me correct this. My origin is angular.main.js. Okay, so now these three variables have been defined. Now we want to show it on UI, but what are the ways in HTML to modify any data on UI? So let me tell you, the first one is input box, second one is text area, etc. You can take anything which works fine with modification thing. Okay, so I'm not going to go in that much. I'm simply taking one input box. Okay, and now the concept of two-way binding in AngularJS come, that in AngularJS there is one very important directive, that is ng-modal. Okay, this is that directive which is useful for binding any particular variable to any particular HTML tag. Okay, how it is done? First let me again explain you that ng-modal is used to bind the variable from controller to the UI. How? So let me show you. Let us show first name. First name. Let us take an input tag, input type equals to text. I'm not going to explain these all because these are the basic HTML tags and you should be knowing before learning AngularJS. Now here we will define our ng-modal. Okay, and this ng-modal will contain that binder value whatever we want to bind from controller. Suppose here we want to bind first name. Okay, so now it means that ng-modal equals to first name. This ng-modal will search for first name in controller. So here he will find that first name is my name dot angularjs, and it will show in this input tag. Now when you modify this first name, this will automatically modify the first name variable in controller. Got it? And I am printing also here the first name so that actually you can understand that what is exactly happening. Okay, this is printing. Always remember, modification will be done with first name here, and when you will modify it here, it will first go to first name and then it will modify the first name here. When we will run this application, we will understand that what I'm telling. So simply let's move further. So second name, again copy paste the same thing. Rather than copying pasting, it is the beginning, let us write. See, you are a beginner, try to type more. Don't try to copy paste more because you will not understand. Now ng model in second name. Now I hope you have understood that what we are going to bind. We are going to bind our last name. If you are interested, you can rename it as last name also, doesn't matter. I'm just showing you that how we will be binding variable. So ng model equals to last name, again this tag will search for the last variable that has been defined, last name that has been defined in our controller. Okay, and this will pick up the value from this variable last name and it will show the value. For showing the value, what we do is we pass the name of the variable and put it in opening and curly braces. One br tag I'm putting so that we can generate these things after new line. And the last one is address. So again, input type text, sorry, it will go inside the double quotes. Let us close this. And ng model one more time, because see, whatever number of variables you want to bind in input box, you will have to pass the name. So this one is variable, address variable. So I have passed it and let us print it. Okay, now let us run this program. I'm not editing, I'm not showing you two-way binding right now. I'm showing you one-way binding that we are taking the first name, we are binding with the help of ng model. This is predefined directive with AngularJS. Whatever variable we will bind, it will pick from controller and will show the value. And for showing the value, you will have to do something like this: two opening curly braces and two closing curly braces and braces. And in that, we will have to define the variable whatever we have defined. So let us run the application first and see. Sorry, it has gone to debugging. Let's alt run and let us run this program. So the server is starting right now and it will give us the output. So here you can see something. My first name is AngularJS. I am first version of AngularJS. You can go here, and my origin is AngularJS. Whatever variable we have defined in the controller according to first name, last name and address. Now simply try to modify this. So if you see, whatever you are changing here, it is also changing for this particular variable. And yes, that is the functionality of ng model, that it binds the first name to the variable defined in controller, and when we will modify this variable on UI also, it will automatically get modified. Got it? So this is two-way binding in AngularJS, that if we get a controller's variable on UI and if we are modifying it, it will, the overall value of the variable name will also get changed. Okay, I hope you have understood this. Now this was the two-way binding. Now what is the utility? Suppose you have a form, and suppose you have one more input, you have a button, and this is of submit type. Type equals to submit, and you want to I'm not going that much deeper, I'm just explaining that what exactly this is, why we need two-way binding. So this, on this submit, we want to modify the value of these three variables and we want to send it to database. So similarly, we will use this concept of two-way binding. We will define with first name, last name, address. We will define three variables and will bind to on our UI. We will modify them, and you can see that now the new variables are this. And through submit button, we will pass all these three variables. How? We will explain, we will learn all these in coming lectures, that how object is created, how submit button works, how new modified variables are sent into database. But till now just learned that what ng model is, what two-way data binding is. So I think you have understood what two-way data binding is. At last, again I would like to remind that ng model simply binds the variable present in controller to the UI, and when we will modify that variable from UI, the variable value, that is my name is AngularJS, will be changed with the value whatever we will give on UI. Like here we are giving this variable, and you can see that this variable has changed to this. So I hope you have learned two-way binding. In next tutorial we are going to learn new things. Thank you, see you in our next tutorial. Bye bye.